There has been a tremendous increase in bike use within the past year. This has led to bike share programs becoming immensely popular as well. The story behind this video is that I was riding my bike on the Ocean Parkway Coastal Greenway on Long Island and stumbled upon these orange bikes at Cedar Beach Marina. I had no idea Long Island had its own bike share system. Whenever I'm in the city, I like to use City Bike, so therefore I instantly became fascinated with what I saw at the beach. For those that are not familiar with bike share, it is a shared transport service in which bicycles are made available for shared use to individuals on a short-term basis for a price. In this video, I will be discussing two bike share programs. The first is City Bike, located throughout the boroughs of New York City, and the next is Bethpage Ride, which is located on Long Island. I will be providing the pricing, usability, and final conclusion for each program. Let's start off with City Bike. City Bike made its debut in 2013 and was an instant success. It has recently partnered with Lyft, a ride-sharing platform, and it is available in 4 of the 5 boroughs. This includes Manhattan, Queens, Brooklyn, and the Bronx. It is even located in New Jersey, and the locations include Jersey City, Hoboken, and Journal Square. City Bike is available for use 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, and riders have access to thousands of bikes at hundreds of stations. There are 20,000 bikes and more than 1,300 docking stations, and this includes e-bikes or electronic bikes. The best way to access City Bike is through the City Bike app, and members also have access via a key, but more on that later. Now it's time for Bethpage Ride. It is currently managed by Pedalshare. It is located in Suffolk County and has 40 docking stations with locations in Huntington, Babylon, Lindenhurst, Cedar Beach Marina, Patchogue, Riverhead, and the Hamptons. When the program launched in September of 2019, there were 100 of these orange bikes and only 17 stations in Babylon, Patchogue, and the Hampton Bays, and it has since expanded to 40 stations and 1,000 bikes. Similar to City Bike, riders can access a bike via the app, in this case, the Blue Map. Here's the pricing for City Bike. Cyclists can opt for the annual membership, which is $15 a month, and $179 billed upfront annually. It provides unlimited 45-minute rides on a classic bike. There's also a single ride, which is $3.50 a trip, and that is one ride for up to 30 minutes on a classic bike. For rides exceeding 30 minutes, the rider pays an additional 18 cents per minute. On an electric bike or e-bike, the cost to unlock a bike is $3 plus 18 cents, with the same policy applying if you exceed 30 minutes on the bike. Lastly, a day pass is also available for $15 a day, and that consists of unlimited 30-minute rides in a 24-hour period on a classic bike. As for Bethpage Ride, cyclists can opt for the hourly ride, where it is $4 per hour to ride, or 4 hours for up to 60 minutes. There is also the daily ride, where the cost is $35 for 24 hours. And lastly, the annual membership, which is $59, and it offers unlimited rides for up to an hour, with the standard hourly rates applying after the hour. Now it's time to check out some of these bikes. Let's kick it off with City Bike. I rode the bike in Long Island City from Rainey Park to Two Coves Park. It was about a 1 mile ride. I found finding a docking station super easy using the app. Releasing a bike for me was no issue, and within seconds I was on my way. As I mentioned earlier, City Bike members can receive a key to release the bike. It makes accessing a bike super easy because you do not need to use a phone to unlock the bike. But with regards to the app, it is one of the easiest to use in my opinion. It is straightforward and user-friendly. You can look up your previous rides and see how many bikes are available at each docking station. City Bike also has many promotions, some being free unlocks on the bikes. The app also provides transit information for the buses and trains. The bike has a gear shift located on the right and a bell on the left. Adjusting the seat was easy. City Bikes are relatively heavy bikes. They are meant to take a lot of use. returning the bike into the docking station was quick and easy. Slide the bike into the dock and wait for the green light and beep. To conclude, City Bike is a great form of transportation for when you need to get around anywhere in the city. The app is user-friendly and the bike is very comfortable. Releasing and returning the bike was very easy and fast. Now let's move on to Bethpage Ride. Time to hit the suburbs. I will be riding from Babylon Village Pool to Toadon Place. It is about 1.5 miles. I noticed the app was not as user-friendly as the City Bike app. Then again, the bike share program is relatively new, and I would like to think that the app will be tweaked down the road. If you are in a location that is not near a Bethpage Ride docking station, the map on the app won't show you a station. Rather, it will default you to your current location. I just realized that rhymed. Wow. The difference between City Bike and Bethpage Ride would definitely be the docking stations. The bike is locked with a cable and locking mechanism on the rear wheel. In addition, upon releasing the bike, I noticed the bike was still locked. I had to release the pedal in order to free up the locking mechanism on the rear wheel. However, once I was able to free it up, riding it was super easy. Like City Bike, the bike was also very heavy and is designed to be long-lasting and hard-wearing. Check out this ride. I will be completely honest, it was very challenging returning the bike to the Toadon Place docking station. At first, I was trying to lock the bike using the cable. At this point, I went to my phone and swiped to end my ride. It kept on giving me the same message though. It was at that point where I realized I also had to lock the bike using the rear wheel lock. To lock the rear wheel, you have to release the gray lever, which will reactivate the lock. This took about 30 minutes and required a phone call to customer service. I also noticed the app was having issues recognizing that the bike was back in the docking station. However, at the end, I did receive a confirmation that the bike was successfully returned. Now that I know what to do, I should not have an issue anymore. Overall, I was extremely impressed with the Long Island Bike Share program Bethpage Ride. It definitely has some potential to be a really great program and be another form of transportation for Long Island residents. The app needs some simple bug fixes, especially when returning the bike to the docking station. I believe if Pedal Share tweaks up the app to make it more user-friendly, you will see an increase in ridership system-wide. The bikes are located in feasible locations. I believe all it takes is additional support, which leads me to this. This is the Long Island Greenway, a proposed bike trail that would connect Manhattan to Montauk. In September of 2021, Long Islanders called for state support to extend the Empire State Trail. The Long Island Greenway is a proposed bike trail project. The goal is to create a bikeway that will connect Manhattan to Montauk. and the first phase is a 25-mile section that begins in Eisenhower Park and ends in Brentwood State Park. A budget to complete the project will be presented to the governor in December. In the proposal, the construction is set to take place in 2022 and 2023. With the proposed Greenway, I see a major opportunity for Bethpage Ride to expand, making Long Island a more bike-friendly region. For more details about the Long Island Greenway, I have provided a link in the description. Long Island, it's up to you for a chance to be a part of this incredible Empire State Trail. Thank you for watching, and happy riding.